Mickey and Mom. Dad, John. All right.
37-year-old Vanessa Garza, happily married, a mother of two, with a successful career. She was living her dream until she was diagnosed with an AVM.
What was your reaction and what was going through your mind?
I thought from time to time that I was dying. When I would, you know, research, only the terrible stories come up. Death, paralysis, memory loss, stroke, brain bleeding, words that I couldn't even comprehend.
Scans showed Garza's AVM was quite large.
It was spread out. It was diffuse. And that can make the removal of the AVM more complicated. So the procedures might interfere with good parts of my brain. And due to the fact that I had never had a rupture or a seizure or even chronic headaches, the doctors at the Brigham and Mass General and Dartmouth said, you leave your AVM alone. There are multiple modalities to treat AVMs, one of them being medical management. We watch it and we cross our fingers and hope that it doesn't rupture.
Garza realized if she chose treatment, she was betting on her AVM rupturing, and that might not be the case. Brain surgery had its own risks. Doctors warned she could lose her sight, or worse. A gut-wrenching decision, gambling on her life, Vanessa rejected surgery. Would the odds be in her favor?
At first I was at peace, and it was actually a huge weight of relief off my shoulders. They said to leave it alone. I'm at the best hospitals in the nation. I'm gonna leave it alone. And done.
But living with an AVM was nerve-wracking.
The anxiety of this ticking time bomb and the emotional state that I was in was too much for me to bear.
Dr. Aman Patel is a neurosurgeon at Mass General.
Well, the first thing I do is try to convince them that they don't have a ticking time bomb. You know, say you make the diagnosis at the age of 40, you tell them, well, look, you went through your entire first 40 years and it hasn't caused any trouble. There's a reasonable expectation that you can go through the next 40 years without it causing any trouble. The only difference is now you know it's there, so that's part of the trouble.
Surgery is not the only option to treat an AVM.
Operating on an AVM is one treatment. Radiation with radiosurgery, gamma knife, is another option. And we have a third option in which we use glue from inside the blood vessels to close off AVMs. And what the gluing does is diminish the flow in the AVM, which makes the surgery safer.
But remember, Boston surgeons felt Vanessa's AVM was best left alone. She and her husband, Ryan McAllister, considered all options.
If you have a rupture where it's random event, random time, you have no control, you know, it's effectively a stroke. So you can have outcomes that from loss of motor function to loss of sight, to loss of speech. I mean, so many things can go wrong with these things.
Vanessa decided she couldn't live with her AVM, so she sought one last opinion. She sent her scans to a surgeon out of state. He suggested a craniotomy with a one-time embolization. That's where glue is injected into the AVM to prepare it for surgery.
For my family, for my children, for our future, it was something I had to do. I couldn't sit back and let this AVM take hold of me. I wanted to be there for my children, so I thought, I have to do this.
It's like, you know, the pit and the pendulum, right? You've got this like thing hanging over your head, and people say, just try to live with it, ignore it. And it got to the point with her where she's like, I just can't live with this thing.
Garza booked her surgery and prepared to face the unknown.
Vanessa obviously did a lot of homework. She researched AVMs like crazy, and then she talked to a lot of doctors.
Well, she was afraid. She was afraid that something was going to happen when she was alone with her children or when she was driving a car. But she was very happy that all the doctors that she spoke with said, seek other opinions. See what's out there. So I think that was great advice for her.
Up next, a conversation no married couple wants to have.